Welcome everybody, my name is Ola El Hosseini. In this tutorial, I am going to show you how to use XLOOKUP to evaluate multiple conditions. In this example, we have the salaries for each employee, and I want to retrieve the tax rate for each salary to calculate the taxes for each employee. Okay, before I show you how to do this, please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell button to receive the upcoming videos. Now, let me show you how to do this. The first step, we have to create table for the salaries level and its related tax rate. Okay, in this table, we have multiple salary levels and we specify the tax rate for each level. Okay, for instance, if the salary is greater than or equal to 1,000 and less than 3,500, the tax rate will be 10%. And if the salary is greater than or equal to 3,500 and less than 5,000, the tax rate will be 15%, and so on. Okay, the second step, I am going to calculate the or retrieve the tax rate for each salary by using the XLOOKUP function. Okay, the first step, we have to highlight the cell, and in the formula bar I type equal, then XLOOKUP. Okay, XLOOKUP takes 6 arguments. The first argument is called lookup value. This is what we want to look up. Okay, in this case I am looking up for the salary. Okay, so I select C2, then type the list separator. The list separator could be comma or semicolon based on your computer setting. In this case, the list separator is comma. The second argument is called lookup array. This is the array all range to search. In this case, the lookup array is the salary range. So I select taxes sheet, then the salary range like this, and be sure the range to be fixed by press F4. So when we copy down the formula, the cell reference will be fixed. Okay, the third argument is called return array. This is the array or range to return. In this case, I want to return the tax rate range, so I highlight the tax rate range like this and make it fixed by press F4. So when I copy down the formula, the cell reference will be fixed. Okay, then type the list separator. The fourth argument is called if not found. We specify the value which we want to return if the exact match or is not found. Okay, so I want to return I want the cell to be empty, so I type double quotation. The fifth argument is called match mode. It has multiple options. In this argument, we specify the match mode. In this case, I want if the exact or the valid salary is not found, I want to return the next smaller item, so I select the second option like this. Okay, the sixth argument is called search mode. This argument has multiple options. In this argument, we specify the search way. I want the search way to start from the first item to the last, so I select the first one. And we can also select the third option, but in this case we have to sort your data based on the salary column from the smallest value to the largest ascending sort. So, but in this case I want to select the first option because I want the search to start from the first item to the last item. Okay, and then type the closing parentheses and press enter. The last step, I want to copy down the formula. So from the right corner, I double click like this. So now I can retrieve the tax rate for each salary. Okay, that's it. If you like the content, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching and see you in another tutorial.